Welcome user, in the last video we have seen third purpose of exploratory data analysis. In this video we are going to see last purpose of exploratory data analysis. For the second and third purpose I have used MBA dataset. For the fourth purpose also I am going to use same dataset. And at the end we are going to conclude how these purposes are related to each other with respect to data. So let us start. Under the workspace tab, you can see imported MBA dataset. Now let us see the code and run the code one by one. If we check bar graph of WorkX feature, we are not able to find out useful information. Now check bar graph of GMAT feature. Here also we are getting same type of visualization. So we can conclude final note. For this dataset, we can say bar graph is not giving any useful information. Now check visualization by using QQplot. Right here you can see QQplot of WorkX feature. Blue color represents data points. Over here we can conclude all the data points are not near to red straight line. There are couple of points which are away from the line. Maybe we can assume these are our outliers. Check QQplot of GMAT feature. Again we are getting same type of graph. So we can conclude final note, both features are not normally distributed. Now check histogram of WorkX feature. By looking into the graph, we can say tailing end is located at right side. So we can say data is positively skewed and outliers are present on the right side of graph. Also peakedness is more. So we can say data having huge positive kurtosis value. Now check histogram of GMAT feature. Over here we can say tailing end is located at left side, so we can conclude data is negatively skewed and outliers are present on the left side of the graph. Also peakedness is more, so we can say data having a positive kurtosis value. Finally we can conclude for WorkX feature skewness value is positive and kurtosis value is also positive. And for GMAT feature skewness value is negative and kurtosis value is positive. Now let us check scatter diagram. By looking into the graph, we can't conclude anything. So I'm moving towards the box plot. This is our lower extreme. This is our first quartile. This is median. This one is third quartile. And the upper one is upper extreme. And these red points, we can say these are our outliers. From this graph, we can conclude following points. First point is outliers are present above the upper extreme. Second point is length of second whisker is more as compared to length of first whisker. So overall we can say data is positively skewed. Boxplot of GMAT will tell us following points. First point is outliers are present below the lower extreme. Second point is length of first whisker is more as compared to length of second whisker. So overall we can say data is negatively skewed. Over here you can see the final note of each plot or graph. In the previous video, we have calculated skewness and kurtosis value of both feature. This is the output window we got for the last video. First, let us see the conclusion of each plot or graph. Bar graph is not giving any useful information. If we talk about QQplot, we have concluded that both features are not normally distributed. If you recall the second lesson of this chapter, we can validate above conclusion with value of skewness and kurtosis. We know that if and only if value of skewness and kurtosis are 0, then data shows normal distribution. So we can validate this statement with numerical values of skewness and kurtosis. Now talk about histogram. For WorkX feature, we have concluded skewness value is positive and kurtosis value is also positive. And if we validate these statements with numerical values of skewness and kurtosis, both are matching. Also you can validate same thing for GMAT feature. Now I am moving towards the box plot. For WorkX feature, box plot shows data is positively skewed and if we validate with skewness value, then yes, we have a positive skewness value. And for GMAT feature, box plot shows data is negatively skewed and if we validate with skewness value, then yes, we have a negative skewness value. This will end our video. In this video, we have seen last purpose of exploratory data analysis. Also, we have validated purposes. In the next video, we are going to see detailed analysis of outliers. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. If you have any queries, post them in the comments and get in touch with us. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Education is our future, MATLAB is our feature, happy MATLABing.